Wave 105, welcome to the evening show, the legend that is Sharleen Spiteri.
The legend.
The most down-to-earth person ever to set foot through these doors
again.
That's
only because I've been dissing your filming techniques here. That's the only thing.
Just to explain, if you do see the clip of this, just for various technical reasons, it's being filmed on a phone today rather than on the usual Wave 105 showbiz equipment, but it's fine, isn't it?
Well, the filming on the phone's not the problem. The filming is the man behind the camera who has to hold it still for however long we're going to be here for.
And who knows?
Which we've not actually given him any length of time. And I can see him shaking just because he's laughing, which is just, so when you see the shake on the film, it's not me that's shaking. Anyway,
how many years is it? Well, it's obviously been 25 years, hasn't it? But it seems like to me, in my brain, it doesn't seem that long. So,
do you know what? I don't know. I thought that was just in my brain, but obviously, maybe it's an age thing for us.
I think it must be, mustn't it?
But it doesn't. It really doesn't feel like it. It really feels like
five, six years ago.
Yeah, it feels still. I kind of still feel as if I'm sort of just starting out.
And how come you're still doing it after all these years? When so many people get fed up and go off and do other things, you must still be absolutely loving it then, to be making music.
I do
music.
Love it. You know, I mean, I think the truth is, I mean, we have been lucky enough to have a very successful career. There was a bit of a gap at one point, but we took some time off because we'd never taken time before. And before we put the conversation out last year, there had been a kind of almost like there was like a 7-year gap between records, but Ali, our guitarist as well, had a grade 5 brain aneurysm, so that kind of soaked up quite a few years, and having children and all that kind of stuff, so there was a few years of that, and then went back to making Texas records and being on tour.
Thing is though, you haven't changed at all. You just have not changed at all.
He says as he's getting booked in for his eye operation.
I'm talking about orally. Okay. The voice is the same, obviously.
Visual. I never thought I'd get. I've not heard that line before. Orally.
Oh, that's
not changed. Orally.
With an AU rather than an OR. Obviously, facially, you've not changed at all either. Just cover my arse here. But musically,
he's
the,
like that.
The
he's
voice.
Thinking, I'm seeing to a woman, I better just like.
Just
cover,
whatever you do.
Just cover. Just like, yep, yeah. Uh-huh, mm-hmm.
So what is it? I mean, you know, you must. Your voice, I would have thought, would change over 25 years, but yours just literally has not changed at all. Obviously, the T is helping.
I had a bit of a glitch, it would have been maybe 12 years ago when I got nodules. And that was a bit of a scare. And then what was really weird about it is that after I had the nodules, I didn't have them operated on or anything. They were lucky that they were still in blister form for me and they hadn't gone hard. And one night on stage, my voice just packed up, just stopped dead. And I get a real fright because there's one thing I love to do is sing. And I basically did everything that the doctors told me to do. And I didn't speak for 3 months. Not even a peep.
Not even whispering.
No, that's the worst thing you can do is you can't whisper and you can't talk loud. Everything's got to be, once you do start doing stuff, I had to do exercises at first, like, and you blow down a tube into water, because when you blow and do sounds, it doesn't in any way stretch the vocal cords. And I did everything that I was told, and lucky enough, my voice came back, but it actually came back stronger than ever. But the one thing is it gets tired faster. So I have to be careful. I do have to watch what I'm doing. But my voice is stronger, but in a weird sense, I don't get so much, time out it now. You know, I'll do shows and literally I shut up after it. There's no chatting or anything. I have to be careful.
You only do the one encore afterwards,
No, because I can't help myself. If there's encores to be had, I'm taking them.
It must be so weird. I'm just trying to think, you know, what you would do if somebody phoned you. If you can't speak,
don't answer the phone.
You can't answer, can you? There's
no, you just don't answer the phone.
It's for literally three
Phone's
months.
Really bad for it. Phone is literally really, really bad for your voice.
Why?
Apparently because you use a different muscle when you're speaking on the phone, because the way you speak on the phone.
Do you have a special telephone voice? My mum does.
But she'll I love the fact that some people do it, and it really made me laugh. It's that bit in, what's the movie, Wolf of Wall Street, when they talk about the dad that answers the phone, and he's American, he always puts on the English accent. Hello!
Yes.
How are you?
Can I just say, Brittany, you've obviously seen the film, one of the funniest films.
Oh, it's hysterical. Some people really hate that movie, but I've seen a few of those faces and a few of those situations. So yeah, for me, I was like kind of going.
Just getting a mental picture now of the private life of Sharleen Spiteri, sitting down, watching a video, saying nothing, with a nice cup of tea.
Lovely, and a slice of toast.
Yeah. Is there anything you can, you're not supposed to eat, you're not supposed to drink on the subjects of your voice, or can
you're never supposed to drink really hot or really cold. You know, everything's supposed to be relatively room temperature sort of thing.
Sounds very, very dull.
It is very dull. It's very, very dull. But if you want to do what you want to do, then sometimes you've got to be really dull.
And speaking of doing what you got to do, you've brought your guitar.
I have.
And you're going to do the single, which we've been playing for ages here.
Really? Oh, good. Five.
So it's called Make a Family. What's the story behind the single?
Start a Family is, it's about choices. It's about roads in life that you choose to take. Yeah, I think the first two lines of the song sort of sum up. You can start a family or you can start a war. And that's how it goes, whether it's a personal war with your loved ones, or whether it's a war with people on the outside, or whether it literally is a war. And right now, here and now, it seems more poignant than ever, the song, the way things are right now. It's about not always having to be making those choices on your own. You can choose to live as a family if you want. And I don't just mean that in a literal sense. I mean as in, sometimes you're closer to your friends and people around about you than you are to your family, but they are your family. So it's talking about all that kind of stuff.
That's the story behind the song. You hardly need to perform it, but you're going to do it for us anyway. And can I just say, is it my imagination or is that really small guitar?
No, I'm really big and this guitar is just normal. And
it's a small
guitar,
isn't it?
I'm gigantic. I'm a really big person.
It's a small guitar.
It's a small guitar. It's my little piccolo. No, it's my little travel guitar. It's a small guitar, big sound. Bit like myself.
Here we go.
You can start a family, you can start a war. Begun with good intentions, now you don't know what you're fighting for. There's no way of knowing the way you are today. When I look up to the sky, there's only one thing that I wanna say. Lay down, try and talk about it. Lay down, don't scream or cry or shout it. Stay down, don't deny or doubt it. No one knows you better than me. The world's a little darker through your end of view. When the times get harder, know I'll always be there for you. There's no way of knowing, but I'll guess if I may. When I look up to the sky, there's only one thing that I wanna say. Lay down, try and talk about it. Lay down, don't scream or cry or shout it. Stay down, don't deny or doubt it. Cause no one knows you better than me. Ooh. Ooh. down. Try and talk about it. Lay down. Don't scream or cry or shout it. Stay down. Don't deny or doubt it, 'cause no one knows you better than me. Lay down. Try and talk about it. Lay down. Don't scream or cry or shout it. Stay down. Don't deny or doubt it, 'cause no one knows you better than me.
Love it. Sharleen Spiteri here on Wave 105. That is on the album, which is called Texas 25,
yep.
Celebrating 25 years, as we mentioned, which only seems like 10 at the most of Texas. But it's all been reworked in a very special way, hasn't it? It's a completely different kind of sound.
Yeah, we went off to New York, Nashville. We were in London and Glasgow as well, doing bits and pieces. So we went and we completely re-recorded the whole album as one record. So the interesting thing was taking songs that some of them were written and recorded when, you know, I was 18 years old, and some of them were done, you know, way later. So it's all the hits that people know alongside the four new songs, but recorded as one album. And we enlisted our friends Truth and Soul, who are a New York soul collective, young guys who you'll probably know from playing on records. You'll have heard them playing on records like the Amy Winehouse records, Black Keys, Yellow Black records. So yeah, they're amazing musicians, and they did some stuff with me on the solo record Melody that I did years ago. So we knew them from then, and it was interesting because, you know, some of them had never even heard any of these songs before, and it was good having that freshness and input, and you know, no preconceived ideas of how big they'd actually been as hit records already. So they were like really fresh and new to it, and we just went in and we played, and we saw where the songs went here and now, and you know, they're different, but they're not so different that you'll not recognize them. You know, they're there, but they're taking on a slightly different atmosphere.
And you're taking the show on the road as well, aren't you? You're going to be doing almost like an acoustic kind of strip.
Well,
we're taking
a show on the road, which is the 25th anniversary celebration, the beginning of it. It'll be the first part of you know, a tour that's going to hopefully go on for quite a long time. And the first part is going to be a very stripped down skiffle band, but it'll be mostly the show will take on the audience of where they want to take the show. So there'll be like a lot of chat, there'll be a lot of talk about how the records were made and the background behind the songs, and you know, I'll be doing a bit of social networking. I'll be doing stuff on my Instagram, putting up maybe some old photographs and saying, okay, let's discuss this, let's discuss, you know, eye makeup, or, you know, bad underwear, whatever we want to do. I'll decide on a couple of days before whatever shows I'm playing, and hopefully we get quite a good bit of feedback through that, and that will be part of the show. So every show will be completely different. It'll really depend on how the audience want to take it.
It's an interesting thing as well, you've brought up social media and Instagram stuff. When Texas was first around, the internet had hardly even been invented, had it? So things have changed
massively. Like, we didn't even at that point, you know, records weren't even made on computers at that point in at home. So, you know, even just the way that the records have made, and that sort of came into it, and then the way social media has changed, it's changed everything about music. It's an exciting time that, you know, there's a lot of young new bands out there that can basically market, you know, distribute their own music, put it out there to be heard, build up an audience, basically without any help of anybody. And it's an interesting time. It's kind of it's funny because it's so advanced, and you know, it's something completely new, but it's also got that feel of almost punk, of, you know, the rebellion against the big companies and the sort of the masters, as they like to be known, of you can't do anything without them. But it's almost gone back to that whole thing of the music. Without the music, there's nothing, and people can put it out there themselves, and they can make these records themselves. And it's going to be interesting to see where that goes.
Do you think the music's become more disposable now because you can download it? Anything you can get for free if you look hard enough.
I think what's more worrying is we've allowed music to really be cheapened. That does worry me a great deal. You know, it seems to be that so many people are kind of will go on and do a crap karaoke version of a song and suddenly become a superstar overnight, and it's just a stepping stone for them to become a TV star or a, you know, a radio star, a media star, whatever, anything like that. And I think it's that slightly bugs me. I don't think that's a great way, because music's been allowed to be used by companies, and catalogue is everything. And the shame about it is that to create and make new music, you know, there has to be a place for that new music to be heard and to be put out there. And let young artists build their own catalogue. So it's a difficult, it's a really difficult time. It's a very difficult time. You know, there's not a lot of money in the music industry at the moment. And you know, you get young bands that can't afford to basically go out on tour with, you know, the big bands, unless the bands are just going to take them out and it's getting to hear their CDs and getting to hear their music. But you kind of got to keep your ears open and your eyes open, stuff that's online or whatever. If you come across anyone interesting, you know, you'll be able to find an easy way to get a hold of people again through social media, which is again an interesting time. But, you know, making records and getting them out there, at the end of the day, it takes a lot of time and a lot of love and a lot of attention to detail. But without the music, there's nothing.
Well, there we go. What a way to end. Without the music, there's nothing. Right, a definitive final comment from Sharleen Spiteri. Thank you very much for popping back into Wave 105.
Not at all.
No doubt, hopefully we'll see you again in the near future. Thank you.